friends, my name is Katie. Welcome back to my channel, Life Between Words. I wanted to do a really quick unboxing today. At the beginning of this month, I found a... Guys, my brain isn't working today. At the beginning of this month, I found a discount to try out the book box called Book of the Month. And Book of the Month is a really interesting subscription box because at the beginning of every month, you get a choice of like 5 different books and you can choose which one you want. And I like that because then I know that I'm going to get a book that I'm interested in and that I am looking forward to reading. So it's a little bit different than other book boxes where it's kind of a crapshoot what you get. This one, I know what I'm going to get, but I'm still excited to unbox it. So anyway, I got a discount to try out this subscription box for 3 months for like $20. So I think normally it's a little more expensive than that. I think it was actually like 50% off. But anyway, let's unbox it and I will show you what I got. Alright, doing this on camera is going to be a little tricky. Alright, so it's just, there's not a whole lot in this. Let's open this up. It came all wrapped in some plastic wrap. So let's see here. So I got a little postcard, a little note from someone named Liberty who says, "If you are reading this note and you are on a plane, put this book down now. Safe on land, then please continue on and enjoy reading this intense story of privilege, survivor's guilt, and redemption wrapped around a whodunit. I actually gasped when the cause of the crash was revealed. It's so good, but seriously, don't read this on a plane." Noted. I will not read this on a plane, and since I'm not planning on flying anytime soon, I think I'm safe. And then a little Book of the Month. Seriously, my brain's not working. What is this called? Bookmark! With a quote on the back by Jeanette Walls that says, "One benefit of summer was that each day we had more light to read by." That is so true. And then the book I chose this month is called Before the Fall by Noah Hawley. And I think this is kind of a thriller mystery type book, and it was the only choice that really sounded interesting to me this month. Well, there were a couple that sounded interesting, but this one was my favorite of the bunch. These must be printed specifically for Book of the Month because on the back it says I Heart Book of the Month. That's kind of cool. And also, I'm just going to put another plug in for The Modern Mrs. Darcy because apparently I'm doing that a lot, and why not just put another plug in? So The Modern Mrs. Darcy is one of my favorite bloggers, and every summer she puts out a summer reading guide. She suggests a lot of books that are great for summer reading, and she splits them up into categories. Sometimes they're new releases, sometimes they're older releases, but just appropriate for the summer. This is one of the books that was on this summer's list, and so that's another reason why I chose this particular book, because The Modern Mrs. Darcy recommends it. It's usually a good bet that I'm going to like it. So I'm just gonna maybe read the inside so we can all figure out what's going on. On a foggy summer night, 11 people, 10 privileged, 1 down on his luck painter, depart Martha's Vineyard on a private jet headed for New York. 16 minutes later, the unthinkable happens. The plane plunges into the ocean. The only survivors are Scott Burrows, the painter, and a 4-year-old boy who is now the last remaining member of an immensely wealthy and powerful media mogul's family. With chapters weaving between the aftermath of the crash and the backstories of the passengers and crew members, including a Wall Street titan and his wife, a Texan-born party boy just in from London, a young woman questioning her path in life, and a career pilot, the mystery surrounding the tragedy heightens. As the passengers' intrigues unravel, odd coincidences point to a conspiracy. Was it merely by dumb chance that so many influential people perished, or was something far more sinister at work? Events soon threaten to spiral out of control in an escalating storm of media outrage and accusations, and while Scott struggles to cope with fame that borders on notoriety, the authorities scramble to salvage the truth from the wreckage. Amid pulse-quickening suspense, the fragile relationship between Scott and the young boy glows at the heart of this stunning novel, raising questions of fate, human nature, and the inextricable ties that bind us together. I'm very excited to read this, and I think what I'm going to be doing is I will read the book that I receive in the book of the month after. So I will try and read this in July, and I will let you all know what I think. So anyway, I'm really excited to read this, and I just thought I'd do a little unboxing for you today. So that's all. I will talk to you guys next time. Bye!